get it.
And making a change here.
This is part two of the game, people. And I hope y'all caught part one. And basically looked at everything that's going on part one. But I'm going to extend this to a third part so y'all can go ahead and see the stats of the game. I couldn't fit the last bit of the part. The reason why I make such long videos with the games, because I want y'all to see the whole game entirely. Some of the stuff I did edit, some of the stuff I did cut out, you know, like some of the timeouts and stuff like that. But I wanted to bring it to you so y'all could actually see in-game basically what it is, what I do. So that's a good pass by me, by Fisher. Took us all in the last play. And I want y'all to actually look at the play. I mean, look at the game. And just tell me what it is that you see. Tell me some things that, some of the stuff that you didn't like or some things that you're not feeling. And that's really skeptical about the game. You know, so there are certain things in the game that I did that I want to bring to the table with y'all so y'all can actually see for yourself. So as y'all see right now, the game is close. And it was a good game. I'm not going to take nothing away from it. You know, it was a good game. And, you know, I did, try and get it, you know, good for you so you could actually see it all entirely and how everything went down in the game. And right now, it's halftime. And I want y'all to look at the stats. And look how the stats do add up. Now, I'm shooting a good percentage from the field, but I'm down by three. But the reason why he's in the game, because I got 8 turnovers in the game to his 5. Now, that's one thing about me that I do say about myself that I do that I need to cut down on is my turnovers. Because I do get a lot of turnovers in the game. And, you know, that's just how I play. I do get a lot of turnovers. I've been like that when I play live. I get a lot of turnovers because I like to attack the basket. I attack the rim, you know. But me personally, when I play certain players and I play you a lot, and when I do play people, it's like I learn how you play. So if you don't have a high basketball IQ and stuff like that, you're not going to really find out anything about it. Now him, when I played my brother, you know, is that he uses, like I said, he uses the animations and a lot of the exploits to his advantage. And that's what he does. He thinks that a lot of stuff that's in here are like, you know, it's supposed to go down like that. It's not supposed to go like that. But I don't want to talk about him. He's a player. That's how he plays. And you have a lot of individuals that do play like this. You know, this is not really the game that he really, it's a button mash game on some things that he does. The next game that I'm going to put up is a button mash game. When y'all see that next game, I think it's the Heat game that I did with him. And when you see that game and y'all really look at it, you will actually see, because he tried to adjust his defense and what he wanted to do. And I'm going to tell you exactly what it is, what he does. And a lot of cats do this as well. A lot of cats don't know how to play man-to-man defense. So what they do is, with them not having basketball, without having them knowing anything about defense, and they don't know how to play defense, they go into a zone, okay? They think a zone is going to work. Now, don't get me wrong. If you know how to use the zone and manipulate the zone, then it will be effective. But if you have a team that does not use the zone, okay, what's the point of you using the zone? You know, teams that use a zone is like Atlanta, maybe, you know, Golden State. I really can't say Golden State. Atlanta is one. They will use the zone because they have the players to use the ability of that zone. Who else? It's teams that are small. You know, teams that are really small. I can give you a prime example. Even though they don't run it and they don't do it, Miami can use a zone. But they have bigs. They can take it out and they can manipulate and use that zone if they want to use a zone defense, if they could. But a lot of teams don't use zone defense. They play man-to-man. Phoenix is a perfect example of a team that has to use zone. They don't have a particular shot blocker. I mean, they have Robin Lopez, but he's a nice defender on the block. But they are a team that use zone because they like to play small. You have to know the ability of the team to play zone. And some cats don't know how to play zone. But at times, he will manipulate the zone and use certain things that's in the game to manipulate that zone. So when I put that next game up, y'all will actually see what I'm talking about in this game. The reason why I'm posting up my games, and I want y'all to see exactly how I play and what I do, y'all can actually learn from me. Y'all can step y'all 2K game up. As y'all see, I don't be aggressive on defense. I play man-to-man defense as much as I play position defense the best way possible. If the computer does not take control of my players. Prime example, what I mean, a lot of y'all can relate with me and y'all can understand where I'm coming from. When I'm playing defense, like in the first video, like when he dunked on me with Carmelo Anthony, when I tried to play position defense with Ron Artest, the computer moved me far to the left and then he crossed over to the right. Okay, I'm not going to get pushed far that way. Now, if you went, now if he kept on dribbling and I moved myself that way and then he went back and he crossed me up, that's fine. But that didn't happen. What happened on that play was that, you know, I stayed in position and the computer moved me. I didn't move myself. So it's like certain things that be in the game that the computer does manipulate. And it does take control of your characters, like player movement. When you try and drive to the basket, or like certain times in the game when you're trying to control that player, like when you try and shoot the ball, and it doesn't respond. A lot of characters out there, now I know there's a lot of 2K fans out there, there's a lot, don't get me wrong, 2K is a good game. But until they get the control aspect of the game down packed to the point where it's going to be very responsive, it's going to have its problems. Or to the point where it's going to have its problems with the animations determining the game. Now, there are certain animations in this game that do determine the game. Now, there's also stuff in the game where a lot of characters, where they so used to the default settings. Oh, matter of fact, as I bring this up, as y'all watching this is what I mean by default settings and what I mean by players taking those to their advantages and not understanding basketball as a whole. Okay, you know when you, when they get up under you for a steal and you know that's a foul and they draw that animation out and they always tipping it out but they don't call a foul, that's a foul. They allow you to steal the ball or pop it out even with a good ball handler, that's a foul. Sometimes they don't call it, sometimes they do, but most of the time they don't call it. So they'll use that animation to their advantage. As there's certain points in this game that you will see the animations be manipulated. Or there'll be certain times where the animations will determine the outcome of the game. Okay? Like when you pass the ball, they're not looking at it. Or you pass the ball like the layup. Like when you try and go for a lob and they jump up in the air and they knock it down, that's not going to happen in the NBA. If you have a clear path to the lane for a lob, and you have a clear path to the lane for the lob, and they so happen to knock it down, that is called an exploit. Or the next thing is this, when they sit in the middle of the paint, okay, when they sit in the middle of the, when they sit in the middle of the paint and they knock your pass down, that doesn't happen. Okay, if you're sitting in the middle of the paint in basketball and you're attacking the rim, it's going to be two things, and you're not in position for that play. It's going to be a blocking foul because you're not getting yourself out of the under the out of the restricted area for a charge. You're under the basket, you're basically in the middle under the basket, that's going to be a blocking foul. Or you're not going to, or you're going to move out the way, it's not going to be a foul at all. But 9 times out of 10, it should be a blocking foul because you're blocking the path because you're not positioning yourself on defense, okay, to position yourself. Next, let's see. I'll discuss this a little bit more in the next video with that so I can actually show you what I'm talking about. But I wanted to bring it up, bring it to you people so y'all can actually understand what I'm talking about, so y'all can understand where I'm coming from. So at the same time, you know, so... how can I put it? I want y'all to understand, you know, that I don't play a basketball game to, you know, I play basketball games to have fun, but at the same time, I play a basketball game. You know, I play basketball because I love the game of basketball. And I understand the game of basketball, and I know it. I know how basketball should be run. Even though it is a video game, they're supposed to be simulation. It's supposed to, you know, emulate real-life basketball. Like that. Like this defense right here that he did where he brings up every single player up. And they try and steal the ball by sticking their hand out. You can exploit that. There isn't an egg. There is that where you can exploit it and get out of it because that's dumb defense. When you play full court defense, you don't bring your whole team up to cover two guys. But in 2K, they do not allow you to throw the ball through half court where there's no defense. For some particular reason, it does not respond. Okay, and I have done tried it. You know, when you see the next game that I put up after this one, after the third video, it's going to be a game that I put up, and y'all will see it. And I will show you exactly what it is that I'm talking about in the game, so y'all can understand what I'm talking about. And then there's going to be some things that I'm going to show you a lot of players out there, what you can do in the game. I'm going to break it down on what it is that I'm doing in that game. This one, I'm just showing you just some gameplay with me. But in the next one, I'm going to break it down to you and what it is, what I see, what I'm trying to do, and what I'm going to expose him on in the game. Okay, now in that game, it was a real, real good game, and I'm going to put it up, and y'all can see it. Since y'all catching this, and y'all catching this game, you know, like I say again, a lot of cats out there, y'all couldn't get me on my Facebook page. My Facebook link is on my channel. It's on the channel, so y'all can go ahead and go to that link, and y'all can go to my Facebook, add yourself, and I'll have the videos of this video, of all my videos posted up on the channel, and y'all can check it out. But if y'all want to come to the channel, y'all check it out, subscribe, put your comments down. I gladly have anything that y'all want to talk about or talk about the game, because y'all get me on hand when I'm logged in. So, you know, and I'm going to go ahead and put up the third part to this, which will be the last part. And it's a good game the way it ended up. But at the same time, I want y'all to look at the stats. When y'all look at that third video of the game, I want you to look at the stats. I want y'all to look at the percentages. I want y'all to look and understand what I'm trying to get with y'all. Stats is a very, very big key when a person wins. All right, y'all. Thanks for dropping in for part two of this game with your boy Prime in the Matrix. You know? But if you know, you know. But if you don't know, your boy Prime had brought you some more news. All right, y'all. This is about to be closed out. Go ahead and watch part three. All right, y'all. Ghosts.